All right, so here we are on the farm making biochar using the system, the top lit updraft system. So you saw the holes in the bottom of the barrel, and that's used for airflow. We don't want much airflow, so that's why we just have a few small holes in the bottom. Here you can see we're loading the biochar barrel with eucalyptus. In this case, we're using small chunks. We like to cut them down to the same size. It helps for a better and more uniform burn. And then we're doing the top lit updraft. So you can see that we get the fire going on the top here, and that flame, that open orange flame, pretty much stays on top of the material and does not contact the bulk of the material throughout the process. So it takes a little while to get going, but not too difficult to get that going. Obviously, the drier your material, the easier it will be to burn. All right, so now we've put on the top, and here goes the chimney. And when we put the chimney on, this helps create a draft. And it's amazing how this simple addition of a chimney will really start to draw air through the bottom holes, and it will really pull air up quickly. And that helps us get that high heat that we're looking for. So we want low oxygen, high heat. So this is after it's finished. We've doused the whole thing with water after burning it for a couple of hours, after we're confident that all of the material has been pyrolyzed. And we've doused it with water to stop the process. If we were to leave it going all day or longer, we would just end with ash, and we would not have a lot of the carbonized material that we are going for.